Well, we talked about Russian domination. The Protopopov, 64 and 68 Olympic gold medalists. Rodnina and Ulanov, 72. Rodnina and Zaitsev, 76 and 80. Volova Vasilyev at 84. Gordieva and Grigov, gold at 88. And now Natalia Mishkatunik and Artur Dmitriev for the unified team will try to preserve that winning streak as they skate for gold.
They looked really strong on practice this morning, but I'd have to say in the warm-up, she looked rather doubtful. She just didn't seem to have the confidence. She has been having some problems with her single jumps. Opening with side-by-side triple toes. And she didn't get the rotation at all.
Well, with the draw being what it was, they have to go out and try everything because they know that Brasseur and Eisler have a strong packed performance, and they've got to try everything that they've got in an effort to stay in first place where they currently are.
Beautiful throw triple toe loop.
That's the unison Gene Sepp was talking about earlier.
Triple Sao Cow, nicely executed. They've been having no difficulty at all with their throws tonight.
Concern that this was 2 years in a row for the same program, but I don't think anyone's tired of it yet.
Well, aside from the mistakes in her side-by-side, a single jump, a strong performance. The crowd is now getting on its feet, and there's no denying the quality of this program. Choreographically, it's the strongest program here, and the audience realizes it, and I think we're going to see it reflected in the judges' marks as well.
This program has the ability to just leave a spell on the audience, as it did in Munich and as it did here tonight. But you have to wonder, with these two mistakes, will this leave the door open for Lloyd and Isabel? Here's the double axels. And she just pulled out in midair.
That's a single instead of the double that he executed.
She had no problem with the throws, though. Here's the throw triple sal. Perfectly executed.
Now, Barb, she's not in the same costume we saw 2 weeks ago in Lausanne.
No, this is the same costume she wore in Munich last year. She had a new costume on at Europeans, but has gone back to the old costume, and he's in the new costume. So maybe this, she thought this costume would bring her luck. I'm not sure.
She's trying to hold back a little bit of a smile, but I think all in all, they're pleased. Paul, you said that Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler might need a couple of mistakes from Vish Katunik and Dimitriev, and there is some room there, 5-7s and 5-8s for technical marks.
Well, as I mentioned, as the performance was going on, with those mistakes, and having drawn the order of skating that they drew, they knew they had to try everything, because if they hadn't, they might have been in the same position they're in now anyways.
It's interesting, she singled. I talked to some of the Russian people after. Here come the artistic marks, and you hear the crowd responding to those 5-9s. They were surprised she made the double axel in the original program. And those will be tough to beat, but there is room for Brasseur and Eisler. Yet the defending world champions have certainly put down a great set of marks, and they're the leaders with two pairs left. 5-9, 5-8, 5-9, 5-9, 5-9. Often debate about if they're an advantage to skating first or not. On the ice. And in that, Vish Katunik and Dimitriev.